Right now I'm working on my biggest project ever. It's a new MAN TGS 8x8 with 500 horsepower. And on that 8x8, we are going to mount a crane. And that's not just any crane, that's of course an HMF crane from Denmark. Actually, the whole thing started back in 1945. When Arne Bundgaard Jensen founded Højbjerg Maskinfabrik, which today is called HMF Group and is one of the leading crane producers. For me, it is very exciting to get the chance to follow not only the production of my crane, but to get the chance to understand and see how a crane is actually produced. If there wouldn't be any restrictions for vehicles regarding height, weight and weight, very difficult for Scandinavians to say, it wouldn't be so difficult for the engineers to create a crane like that, but actually it is. The steel that is used for the production of the crane is a very special and strong steel, and by complex designs in combination with the stronger material, weight can be reduced so that payload can maintain or even be increased. This steel requires a lot from the welding, and that is one of the reasons that HMF has its own welding academy here in Aarhus, Denmark. HMF is a very modern facility, and there are a lot of robots working there doing the welding and bending of everything, but still there goes a lot of manpower in assembling a crane like that. A quality check is made after each work progress. This ensures the quality that is required for a crane like this. After the crane has been welded, the crane must be painted. And of course, it's no longer just a painting job, but it's way more sophisticated than that. Today, a very sophisticated power coating process is used, which is way stronger than a normal painting job. This requires very much from the preparations, as it must be degreased and deburred. After that, it will be primed, and then first it is ready for the power coating. All cranes are produced on the order of customers and are unique pieces. And even I can see now that this shape becomes a crane later on. Actually, I was very surprised that the crane is tested on functionality and quality after every single working progress to ensure the quality and not first at the end of the production line. It is tested after the welding. Then it's tested after the power coating to ensure the thickness of the layer. Each cylinder on functionality when assembling. The precision of each part that is used for the production. And even every little electronic part is tested at the assembly before it goes on in the production line. Then, of course, if everything is assembled and the crane is ready to leave in Denmark, the crane is tested on functionality, is stress tested on weight and everything, and then it's ready to leave to serve another happy client out there. For me, it has been very exciting to get the chance to get in there and see the production line and get an understanding on how a crane is built. And for me, it means very much because I got an understanding on the quality control during the production, but also the test afterwards. So I am confident about the new crane and I can't wait to get in action. If you like today's show and would like to see more about us creating this monster truck with a monster crane on it, then click on the subscribe button, like the video, comment if you have any questions, and then stay tuned, for there will be much more in the future. So see you soon.